with one of our amazing honorees, Cheech Marin, who is a legendary. To be a part of one of the most legendary comedic groups, how does it feel that people are still impressed by what you do and still laughing and still find you amazing?
Amazing, man. I think that happened because they didn't get it in the first place. You know, we had to come back and repeat it and that shit.
How does it feel to be honored tonight?
It feels really good. I got to think of something nice to say and short so everybody can get back to their party,
right?
You know, because I know what these things are like.
So if you were to give a comedian today who is trying to get to the longevity of your career, what advice would you give them?
Don't make any jokes about Jada Pinkett Smith, I guess.
How has being on the show changed your life?
I mean, here I am on the red, purple carpet.
Purple carpet.
Red carpet, though, celebrating diversity. The fact that I'm welcome at these things is such an honor. It really is. So that's a huge transition.
And who is someone that you're excited to see tonight? What is, you know, I know Cedric the Entertainer is hosting. We've got Phylicia Rashad. Yeah, these are iconic.
I heard I'm always about humor, so probably Cedric.
Okay.
I heard Will Smith might be here, right?
I mean,
even after today.
I mean, maybe.
Philly, I gotta see him.
I mean, the guy who plays Will on Bel-Air is here, so.
That's good.
That's a possibility. So, now that you're here, what are you inspired? What's your next thing? What do you want to do?
My next goal. Actually, I was just talking to some other people. I think I'm the modeling industry that I used to be in, mm-hmm. transitioning out of it, doing more business. So I've been sober for almost 7 years now.
Congratulations.
Thank you. So I've gotten into the beverage industry.
Okay.
So I have my own brand now called Sons that I want to bring out to the world in a couple months.
Wait, say that again?
It's a beverage called Sons, and it's a beverage that will help the sober community to be proud and empower them as well, since I've been sober for so long.
Guys, I am here with the four-time Grammy Award-nominated Kizzo. How are you tonight?
Oh, man, I'm feeling great tonight. Such a beautiful night.
Listen, you look good. Who dressed you? Did you do this yourself or you had some help?
No. My stylist, let me shout her out, Lisa Hong. I hope I pronounced the last name right. She got me right.
Yes, she did. So why was it important for you to come out to this particular event? This is the official Rego Gala, you know, Oscars after party. But what made you want to make your presence known here?
Man, I think, you know, there's so much love in the air and, you know, honoring women, I think, is one of the most important things. You know, I love my mom. She's a great inspiration to me. You know, I have a female business partner. Like, it's just, you know, it's all about women. Let's not lie to ourselves, man. Come on now.
Hey.
So I'm happy to be here and celebrate.
We've known you from social media a lot, but you now have a lot of other projects you're working on now. It's getting bigger and bigger. What are some of the things that you really want people to pay attention to in 2022 for you?
You know what? And I got to be candid about this. For the first time, I just jumped all into the acting and really wanted to take it seriously and you know, really hone in the craft. I mean, I'm in acting class every single week now. Just I'm struggling, I'm growing, I'm learning, I'm letting my guard down, trying to kill my ego. You know, it always plays on our mind when we're trying to accomplish something. You know, so. I just appreciate the process, bro.
How are you tonight?
I'm awesome, man. It's good to be here. It's good to see you. You look amazing.
Well, thank you. So do you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So why is it important for you to come out on a night like this and, you know, make your presence known? And what still excites you about Oscar night?
Well, you know, it's very important to support all our black actors. Anybody doing anything in Hollywood right now that's African-American, I'm excited for. I got a lot of friends and people from New York and Detroit that came, and we just wanted to come out and show our support, and we're trying to break down doors.
How important is it for us to celebrate our own people in diversity and inclusion?
Man, you know, okay, so once upon a time when I was a little boy, the only person that I saw that looked like us at the Oscars was usually Sidney Poitier,
right.
Okay? And now there are a plethora of black and African actors in all sorts of walks, all sorts of roles, and I think it's wonderful. Now, that being said, I don't think that we need the Oscars to celebrate us.
Right.
We have to celebrate us. And when we celebrate us and when we define our great moments and our talents, then everybody else will take notice. Mm-hmm. Because, come on now, if it's black,
it's a hit.
It's a hit. Yeah, come on.
So we've seen you in a lot of things, SBU included.
Yes.
But 2022, with everything opening back up, it's a big year that we want to see a lot. So anything you can let us in on that you got going on for 2022?
I'm gonna tell you the oddest one. I actually was asked to do a voice on The Proud Family, oh. Louder and Prouder, okay, with my good friend Sid and Tommy Davidson and Kyla Pratt. And it was a wonderful opportunity because the role that was written for me was Judge Bird, you know? And so I couldn't believe when I read the script, you know, and I was laughing at it so much. And then I got to meet the writer and I asked her, I said, what inspired you to put me as a judge as opposed to a bailiff? And she said, whenever I used to watch Judge Judy, I used to always think he should be the judge. And so she did it, you know?
Hey guys, we're here with Chef Sean, recording artist, rapper, talented. What brings you out tonight? Why was it important for you to make your way to this gala?
Man, the stars, man. The stars is out.
Yeah?
Yeah, I had to make it out this way. And on top of everything, my pick won Best Actor. You know, shout out Will Smith for winning Best Actor, King Richard.
That's right. That was such an amazing film. What stood out in that film and what resonated with you?
It was powerful. What resonated, he made that role him. He made it himself. You know, he bodied that role.
This is big because Abbott Elementary has hit the screen and it's taken people by storm. Your character is probably the comedic relief of the whole thing. You're so funny. Did you know that show was going to come out and be a smash like it was?
We thought it was going to be good, but we didn't know it was going to be just insanely good. You know,
right?
I mean, it's been a wonderful ride.
Exactly.
Yeah, unbelievable. All over the world, you know, we've gotten in every publication, it seems like, and everyone loves the show.
Exactly, we
yeah,
do.
Yeah.
And with an event like this tonight, how important is it for us to celebrate each other, our own diversity, and the things that we're working on?
It's most important, and I mean, look at this. People that look like you and me.
Yes.
And, you know, there was this, Oscar So White a couple of years ago. But if they come and see this and look at what we're doing, you know, all the progress we're making in terms of directing, producing.
Yes.
Soon we'll own some studios. I mean, we own some, but I'm talking about, Tyler owns a big studio.
Tyler.
Yes, yes. But I'm talking about, we're just getting started.
Miss California. Sabrina, how are you tonight?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing wonderful. It's such a pleasure to see you. How has winning this title of Miss California changed your life?
Oh, it's been a whirlwind. So, you know, I was in college and won, and, you know, at UC Berkeley, and then had to move down to Los Angeles. You know, I'm taking a break from my master's program right now, and it's been great. We went to Cancun. I've traveled all over to the different states for my other sister queens and modeled at LA Fashion Week, and that's been really exciting.
What is something that you didn't know on this journey that, you know, would be a big interest, or has anything kind of opened up to you?
Oh, of course. I've connected with the Compton Cowboys and the Compton Junior Equestrians because at UC Berkeley I was competing on the Cal Equestrian team. So now I get to ride and compete with the United States Hunter Jumper Association with the Compton Junior Equestrians.
Oh, that's absolutely amazing. And what do you want to say to a little girl that's watching you right now? You know, what advice to you know, give them some hope?
Sure, yeah. I definitely had, you know, doubters telling me I would never make, you know, an equestrian team. I had an ex-boyfriend tell me I'd never win a pageant. So I think just, you know, don't listen to the haters. Like, don't listen to people that try to put you down. Like, if you believe in your heart and you work hard, you can accomplish anything you set your mind to.
30 years later, people still identify you with the same role. How iconic is that for you to still be loved and adored for that?
You know, it's interesting because I think there are some people that would think that it would be a negative, but it's not. I mean, it's fact. I mean, I've done a lot of work. I was on Moesha, shows, on Family Matters, CSI. I did all kinds of stuff, Prime Suspect, like lots of work. But people don't know me for that. They know me for the iconic show, The Power Rangers. And the fact that there's so much merchandise, oh my gosh. So like, there's Ninja Turtles now that are the Black Rangers. We got a comic book with Godzilla and with Superman, Batman, Flash, Wonder Woman, of like Cyborg. I'm like, we are now affiliated with these characters that I grew up with and that were, you know, my icons. And so I feel honored. I feel honored to, you know, that my character that I created will live long beyond the time that I'm here. You know, with like, I got about 10 action figures, 3 pops, and it's crazy. 4 comic book series, I don't know. It's like, it's wild.
I appreciate your time, and I was honored to meet you as well.
My pleasure.
The creator of Wordle, who has everybody going crazy right now, because I see everybody playing it and sending me pictures of it all the time. Did you know that the app was going to take off like this?
Absolutely not. I built it a while ago when I was 16, you know, just in my bedroom, and I had no idea it was going to turn into what it has. So I'm just blessed to be here. I'm really honored.
So it's 2022, it's kind of a big year now that things are open. What are some other things that we can see you working on, or some secret projects you have going on that we can expect?
Yeah, absolutely. My latest project is called Puff Count. It helps people quit vaping. So that's my main project I'm working on right now. It's what I'm passionate about. I really want to, you know, build things that help people live healthier lives and, you know, just live longer.
So did you know that your role in Harlem was going to be so iconic, that you're going to be so amazing and people were going to be so blessed to see you on screen?
No, I was just having fun, and the girls are amazing, and the set was just like a fun time. I knew from the writing that the show was different. I knew that I never, you know, because I tell my managers all the time, I'm not auditioning for that. I'm not auditioning for no stereotypes. I don't want to do it. I don't have to do it. Somebody will do it. It's not going to be me. But then when it came out, the reaction was like, and I was like, oh, okay, we did something here.
Right.
We did something, yeah.
So us being at the GRIOT Gala tonight, we're celebrating diversity.
Yes.
And more of us.
Yes.
How important is it for us to celebrate ourselves, our culture, and the amazing things that we do?
I think it's of the utmost importance, because when we get those no's from people and people say, oh no, people won't watch this, or, you know, Tracy Oliver, when she did Girls Trip, before she even did Harlem, they were saying no, that there was no audience for that, and it was one of the highest grossing movies. And so I think because we celebrate each other and ourselves, we get to say, no, I'm going to fight for this and its authenticity so that I can get this, because I know the people want this.
Exactly.